press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, welcome to lecture number 6 of chemical bonding. In the last class, we had gone through the concepts of Cosell-Lewis calculation, Cosell and Lewis concepts, in order to explain about the molecular structure of the compounds, and we had gone through the concepts of a formal charge. By using this formal charge, we are going to calculate the charge, the unit charge present on the particular atom in a molecule due to the unequal distribution of electrons or unequal distribution of bonded pair electrons, that can be calculated by this formal charge. There are some of the calculations to calculate the molecular structure by using this Lewis structure and followed by this formal charge. Okay, the very first one, it is to calculate the total number of valence electrons. Total valence electrons, it can be calculated by using the total number of valence electrons of all the atoms in a molecule minus positive charge plus negative charge. Suppose if the molecule possesses the positive charge, means the total number of electrons, those positive charges should be subtracted. If the molecule possesses the negative charge, means these negative charges should be added into the total number of valence electrons of the atoms. This is the first part. Second one, to calculate the lone pairs. How to calculate the lone pairs? Lone pair of electrons. This can be calculated by using this X total. X total means it is the total number of valence electrons present in an total molecule. Number of atoms are present in a molecule, na? By combining the valence electrons of all the atoms, we are getting this value X total. This X total, if it is subtracted by bond pair of electrons, bond pair of electrons and the electrons which are involved in the bonding, if there is a only one bond, means that equal to two electrons, bonding pair electrons. Okay, this is X total, means total number of valence electrons, followed by it is subtracted by the bond pair of electrons. Okay, this is how we can calculate the lone pair of electrons. After using this concept, so we are going to write the structure of the molecules there. While writing the structure of the molecules, so some of the atoms should get double bond, some of the atoms should get single bond. That means there is an unequal sharing of electron pairs or bonded pairs takes place while writing the molecular structure. In order to find the solution for that, for what reason that unequal sharing takes place, then after the unequal sharing of electrons, what is the structure of the molecule and what is the charge that particular atom can take place? If we can take an example of CO3-2 molecule, here one oxygen atom, it carries double bond, another oxygen atom, it carries a single bond. Okay, here this oxygen atom which possesses 4 bonding electrons, but this oxygen atom which possesses 2 bonding electrons, illi unequal sharing of electrons agide, bonded pair electrons, illi bonded pair electrons 4 ide, illi bond pair electrons 2 ide. In such cases, there is a chance of presence of a charge on a particular atom takes place. Okay, yavudo ondu unit charge ee atoms gal mele irthade, and that charge we can call it as a formal charge. Okay, how to calculate the formal charge for a particular atom is calculated by, how to calculate this, If you consider, if you want to calculate the formal charge on this particular atom, we have to consider the valence electrons of this atom. It is represented by V, valence electrons minus. We have to consider the number of lone pair of electrons present on this particular oxygen atom. That means lone pair of electrons, LP, minus. How much bonds it is going to be formed? What is the number of bonds formed in between this oxygen atom? That is represented by bond pair. That should divided by 2, because these bond pair of electrons which are responsible for both the atoms, it is responsible for carbon atom also, and this is responsible for this oxygen atom also. Okay, by using these three formulas, we are going to write the molecular structure of different covalent compounds. Okay, then today we will move on to the some of the other examples of based upon this Lewis and Cosel's concept and formal charge concept. Okay, next one, you can take an example of so the next example, that is SO4 minus 2 molecule. SO4 minus 2 molecule, it is represented like this, SO. Now we should calculate the total number of valence electrons of this particular molecule. How can we calculate the total number of valence electrons? By using this formula, X total is equal to total number of valence electrons of all the atoms. Here how many atoms are in total? In total we are having 5 atoms. One is sulfur and 4 oxygen atoms. One sulfur atom is there, followed by 4 oxygen atoms are there. Okay, next, how many valence electrons are there in sulfur? There are 6 valence electrons, followed by 4 into 6, that is oxygen also having 6 valence electrons. In total we are having 24 plus 6, 30 electrons plus 2. E2 elinda bantu, where does it 2 came from? This 2 is this 2. That means according to the formula, if it is a negative ion, if it is an anion, then to the total number of valence electrons we have to add those ions, those negative charges. That means these two charges are added to this. In total we are having 32 electrons now, 32 electrons. Okay, in which those 32 electrons, how much electrons belongs to lone pairs? That we can calculate. What is the formula to calculate the lone pair of electrons? Okay, we can calculate it by X total minus bond pair of electrons. Here, how many bonds are made by this sulfur? We have 4 bonds. Each bond carries 2 electrons. Each bond carries 2 electrons. That means 4 into 2, we have 8 electrons. In total, we have 8 electrons. Okay, X total means 32 electrons, bonded pair electrons is to the pa, total 8 electrons today, is that to the total 24 electrons. Okay, now we are having 24 lone pair of electrons. As I already told in the last class that according to the rule, these lone pair of electrons, either they may utilized as a lone pairs or they utilized for the formation of a double or triple bond. They can either utilize as a lone pairs or they may utilized for the formation of a double and a triple bond. Now, what is the next rule? We have to distribute these 24 electrons into the terminal atoms in order to get its stability. In order to make a terminal atoms to get octet configuration, we have to distribute these 24 electrons into terminal atoms. Okay, which are the terminal atoms here? 4 oxygen atoms are the terminal atoms here. Here each oxygen is having 2 electrons, 2 electrons. That means they require 6 more electrons to get the octet. 6 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have provided 6 electrons to this oxygen atom so that it can have 8 electrons now. 2, 4, 6 followed by 8. This oxygen get the octate now. This also same thing happened. I distribute 6 electrons to this oxygen atom. Here also 6 electrons. And this also 6 electrons. Okay, now the valency or the octet configuration of all the terminal atoms is satisfied now. But not only to satisfy this octet configuration of our terminal atoms, we need to satisfy the octet of a sulfur. According to the rule, sulfur or any atom you can take, the central atom, it must contains octet or extended octet also, and it should not less than 8 electrons. Central atom alle minimum octet anna undirbeku athwa extended octet anna undirbeku, but it should not exceed or it should not less than 8 electrons. Here sulfur, it is already having 8 electrons because 4 bonds there. But valency of or covalency of sulfur is 6. It can exist with the maximum covalency. And then I've held the central atom yavaglu, it is always trying to be in a maximum covalency. So the maximum covalency of a sulfur is 6. 6 agbeku antandre here we need 2 more bonds. In the erdu bonds na formation madbeku. In such cases what happens, these two electrons utilize to make one more bond, and these two electrons utilize to make one more bond. Now count the number of electrons on central atom. It is having 12 electrons now, no problem. It is having 12 electrons. It is greater than 8. It is having the possibility to have more than 8 electrons. Central atom, either it should exist with the octet or it should exist with extended octet, both can possible here. Okay, now this is the exact structure of a SO4 molecule, but we are left with these two charges now. These two charges. Then here the doubt rises that which of the oxygen atom should get this negative charge? Which of the atom should get a negative charge? Yavadak barutte ee oxygen bartada, ee oxygen bartada, ee oxygen or ee oxygen? Which of the oxygen atom should get a negative charge in order to solve this problem? Okay, what is the concept of a formal charge? Formal charge means it is the charge present on a particular atom due to the unequal sharing of bonded pair electrons. Here this sulfur and oxygen shares two bond pairs, this sulfur and oxygen also shares two bond pairs, but another two sulfur and oxygen atoms shares only one pair. Here there is an unequal sharing of electrons takes place now. Because of its unequal sharing of electrons, there is a rise of concept formal charge. There is a necessity of that concept takes place here, formal charge. Then how to calculate the formal charge? That is also having a formula. First we have to represent them. Now we should calculate the formal charge of first oxygen. You can take the first oxygen. How to calculate its formal charge? Hey, calculate martira formal charge of first oxygen. Now what is the formula? Valence electrons minus lone pair of electrons, bond pair of electrons divided by 2. If we consider the first oxygen atom, how many valence electrons are there in oxygen? It is having 6 valence electrons. 6 minus how many lone pair of electrons are there here? 2, 4, because another 2 electrons are utilized for making the bond. That is why this oxygen atom, particularly this oxygen atom, it will have only 4 lone pair of electrons. Followed by how many bond pairs are there here? Here we are having 2 bonds. That means how many electrons? 4 electrons. That is divided by 2. Plus 6 minus 6 cancel with each other. So the charge present on the first oxygen atom is 0. it should not possess any type of charge. Like that, the fourth oxygen atom also having the double bond with the sulfur and oxygen. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದೆ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಜೊತೆ, ಇದರ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಕೂಡ ಝೀರೋ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹೌ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಎಫ್ ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ವ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್, ಮೈನಸ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಅಗೈನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೋರ್, ಅಗೈನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೋರ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಪೇರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್, ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ zero. The charge present on this particular oxygen is a zero. Both the oxygen atoms carries zero charges, na? Then what about next? Formal charge on third oxygen atom. Okay, third oxygen atom. Is it the third oxygen atom here? This. Again, valency of a third oxygen atom, six valence electrons are there, minus how many lone pair of electrons are there in this oxygen? It is single bonded oxygen, it will have 6 valence electrons, that means 6 lone pair of electrons are there here, 2, 4, 6 lone pair of electrons. And how many bond pair of electrons are there here? It is making only one bond here, that is why the bond pair of electrons are 2, it is divided by 2, that means it is minus 1, minus 1, 6 minus 7, it is minus 1. So the charge present on this particular oxygen atom is minus one charge. It carries how much charge? Minus one charge. Then what about this? What about second carbon atom? It is also a single bonded oxygen between the sulfur. FC means formal charge on the second oxygen atom, that is, it is also valence electrons present in the oxygen are 6. Number of lone pair of electrons on oxygen also 6, minus the bond pair is also common. Again, this will also have minus 1 charge. That means in this particular molecule of SO4 minus 2, two oxygen atoms which should carry a zero charge and another two oxygen atoms will carry a minus 1 charge. In order to clarify the doubt that which of the oxygen atoms should get the negative charge, either this or this or this or this, in order to clarify this doubt, concept of a formal charge has been introduced. By using that calculations, we easily came to know which of the atom in a molecule should get either positive or negative charge. Yav charge na hondirutte anta ee concept base mele naavu analyze maadu. Okay, is it clear? Next, ninne na velidvi formal charge on anion is equal to, or anion or cation is equal to its charges anta. Sum of the formal charges of all the atoms, one molecule alliro ella atoms gala formal charges anna calculate madidre, if it is an ionic molecule, ion agiddu andre adra charge ge a formal charge equal irthade anta. Okay, here in order to consider formal charge on SO4 minus 2 calculate maadbeku andre, formal charges of first, that is minus 1, formal charge on second oxygen atom also minus 1, formal charge on third and fourth are 0 and 0. Sum of all these charges is equal to minus 2 na, minus 2. So the charge carried by the SO4 atom is minus 2. Sum of all the formal charges in a molecule is equal to its charge. Suppose if this molecule is a neutral molecule in nature, neutral molecule, adakke yavade riti charges irodilla, either positive charge or negative charge, both the charges are absent, then in such cases what happens? The sum of all the formal charges is equal to 0. Sum of formal charges of all the atoms in a molecule, it should equal to 0 irthada. In case of anion or cation, formal charge na koodisidre aa charge ge equal bartade. In case of neutral molecule, so sum of the formal charges is equal to 0 bartade. You must remember this concept. Okay, next, we will move on to the one more example, that is NO2 minus. This is another example, NO2 minus. First we have to calculate the total number of valence electrons. How to calculate it? How many number of atoms are there here? One nitrogen atom plus how many oxygen atoms are there? 2 oxygen atoms are there. How many valence electrons are there on nitrogen? Nitrogen is having 5 valence electrons plus 2 oxygen atoms are there. How many valence electrons are there on oxygen? 6 valence electrons. In total we have 17 electrons plus because of the presence of one negative charge, it should add into the total number of valence electrons, such that total number of electrons, that means valence electrons in this particular NO2 minus atoms, will be 18 electrons. NO2 minus molecularly, the presence of total number of valence electrons is 18 electrons. Now we should calculate the lone pair of electrons. How many lone pair of electrons are there here? How to calculate it? We have to subtract the total number of electrons by bond pair of electrons. How many bonds are there? First we have to consider this. 2 bonds are there. 2 bonds means 4 electrons. 4 electrons means how much we left with? We left with only 14 electrons. These are called lone pairs. You must remember, these lone pairs, either they can utilized as a lone pairs or they can utilize for the formation of double and triple bond. Okay, in order to attain this stable electronic configuration, lone pairs, either they may utilized as the lone pairs or they may utilized for the formation of double or triple bond. Okay, first we have to substitute, or we have to utilize this 14 electrons to satisfy the valency of a terminal atoms. By using this lone pair of electrons, we have to satisfy the octet of terminal atoms, the very first. In madbek naviga 14 electrons na transfer madbeku. Okay, how many electrons are there now here? 2 4 6 plus 2 8. Octet of oxygen is satisfied. Okay, next 2 4 6 8 plus 2 4 6 plus 2 8, octet is satisfied. Again 6 plus 6, 12 electrons have gone, and we left with how many electrons? We left with 2 more electrons, and those 2 electrons are there on the nitrogen atom. Okay, this is how we can distribute the lone pair of electrons. But this particular molecule which carries one charge, that is NO2 minus, then among these 2 oxygen atom, which of the compound will have negative charge? Yav compound negative charge na hondutte, yav atom. Before going to calculate the formal charge on each atom, first we have to satisfy the valency of nitrogen atom. Nitrogen atom na valency na satisfy madbeku. How to satisfy? What is the covalency of a nitrogen? It can have 2 capacities. Either it can form a 3 bonds or it can form 4 bonds. Okay, here in order to satisfy the octet configuration of nitrogen, it is having 2 electrons already. 2 plus 2 4 4 plus 2 6. In total it is having 6 electrons already. It requires how many electrons now? It requires 2 electrons. In such cases, these 2 electrons utilized for the formation of one more bond. Nan avagle helidini ee electrons anna lone pair of electrons, so either they are ready to exist as a lone pairs or they are ready to involved in a bond formation. Eradu cases go ready irutte. Okay na, next, now this molecule is ready to calculate the formal charge. If you consider this as a first molecule, this is a second molecule. How to calculate the formal charge? Formal charge on first oxygen, valence electrons of oxygen is 6 minus. How many lone pair of electrons are there in this oxygen? 4 minus. How many bond pairs are there? here we have two bonds, each bond carries two electrons, in total we are having four electrons, okay. Minus 6, plus 6, it is 0. Formal charge present on the first oxygen atom is 0. 0 charge followed by, if we consider formal charge on second oxygen atom, formal charge on a second oxygen atom. Again, this is also same oxygen atom, valence electrons are 6, minus lone pair of electrons present in this oxygen atom are 6, because it is having a single bond, 2, 4, 6 lone pair of electrons are there, minus bond pair of electrons are 2 divided by 2, 7, minus 7 plus 6, it is minus 1. That means the formal charge present on this particular atom is equal to minus 1. Again, if you calculate the formal charge on a nitrogen also, you can get 0, because the total charge or the formal charge, sum of the formal charge of this molecule or this ionic molecule is equal to its charge now. Already we have minus 1 charge, that means minus 1 charge is 1 dendre and remaining atom should carry a 0 charge. Avered 0 charge, this is minus 1 charge. This is how we can represent the structure of different molecules, by using the concepts of Lewis and Kossel's concept followed by the concept of formal charge. Okay, next. So the next concept, sum of the bond characteristics, that is bond parameters. Here we are going to learn some of the concepts that is regarded with the bonds, nature of the bonds, bond strength, bond length, bond angles, that we are going to discuss under this particular concept. The very first one, it is bond length. Bond length. What is meant by this word bond length? The name itself indicates that it is the bond length. It is the length of a bond. When the bond in a nadivina distance. Okay. If these two are the combining atoms, the distance between the average distance between the nuclei of, it is one nuclei A, this is another nuclei B. It is the average distance between the nuclei of two combining atoms. Yeradu combining atoms nadivina nuclei distance enirutalva adana naveen anta karithivi bond length anta karithivi bond length. Okay, what is meant by this bond length? It is the average, or in the sense you can take equilibrium distance. It is the equilibrium distance between two nuclei of two bonded atoms. Okay, eradu combining atoms ide antandre aa eradu combining atoms gala naduvina nuclei na distance ನಮಗೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್? ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತನ್ನು ಯಾವ ಥರ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಐದರ್ ಬೈ ಆಂಗ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್, ಆಂಗ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸಿಂದ ಆದರೂ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಿಕೋಮೀಟರ್, ಪಿಕೋಮೀಟರಿಂದ ಆದರೂ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಆರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಆಂಗ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟಲಿ? ಓಕೆ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನರಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಅನ್ನು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು? ಬೈ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ಡಿಫ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ಡಿಫ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड, इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड, ओके, बाय यूजिंग दिस एक्सरे डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड्स और इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड्स और एनी अदर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक मेथड्स, बाय यूजिंग स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक मेथड्स वी कैन कैलकुलेट दी बॉन्ड लेंथ एक्सपेरिमेंटली, ओके, वी कैन कैलकुलेट द बॉन्ड लेंथ इन एक्सपेरिमेंटल मैनर बाय यूजिंग दीज मेथड्स, एक्सरे डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड और इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफ्रैक्शन मेथड और एनी अदर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक मेथड्स, ओके. नेक्स्ट, what are the factors that affects, what are the factors affects the bond length, factors affects the bond length, yav yav factors bond length na affect madutte, the very first one, atomic size of combining atoms. If size of combining atoms is today included, size of the combining atoms is today, size of the combining atoms like this, size of the combining atoms like this. With the increase in the atomic size of the combining atoms, the distance between the two nuclei increase aagtade. With the increase in the atomic size of the combining atoms, distance between the nuclei of both the atoms has increased. Nuclei naduvina distance jaasti aagta ide andre length of the bond jaasti aagta ide anta artha. Haudalva, with the increase in the atomic size of participating atoms, there is an increase in the bond length takes place. Okay, here we conclude that greater the size of combining atoms, greater the size of combining atoms, more will be its bond length. Okay, if you take an example of hydrogen molecule, okay, the bond length between this hydrogen molecule is 74 picometer. Okay, we can represent bond length in terms of picometer or angstrom units. The bond length between the hydrogen atom in a hydrogen molecule is 74 picometer. Suppose if you can take a Cl2 molecule, Cl, the average distance between the nuclei of two Cl atoms is 199 picometer. Which factor makes the increase in this bond length means the atomic size. With the increase in the atomic size of a chlorine atom with respect to this hydrogen atom, the distance between the nuclei of both the atoms has increased such that the length between the two nuclei also increases. At the same time, the bond length is also increases. With the increase in the atomic sizes, with the increase in the atomic sizes of the atoms, distance between the two nuclei has increased, thereby distance between the bond length is also increases. Okay, that means size of the combining atoms is directly proportional to bond length. Size of the combining atoms is equal to bond length. ಇದು ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದಲ್ವ, ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೋ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್, ವೇರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್, ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ? ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. If there is a single bond is there in between any two atoms, means its multiplicity is 1. If there are two bonds are there, then its multiplicity is 2. then there were three bonds are there, means it is having three multiplicity, means with the multiple bonds, with the presence of number of bonds, illi one bond ide, illi two bonds aitu, with three bonds aitu, multiple bonds, due to the presence of multiple bonds, how it affects the length of a bond, due to the presence of multiple bonds, with the increase in the multiple bonds, if there is a only one bond, the force of attraction between the atoms and these atoms is there, some force of attraction is there, no? Suppose if we add one more bond to this, multiplicity has increased. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಎರಡು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್, ಎರಡೂ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಗಳ ನಡುವೆ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದಾಗ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್, the both the atoms tries to move near, na, they tries to come closer to each other, with result to that the distance between the two nuclei of combining atoms decreased. I repeat, with the increase of the bonds, with the multiplicity of the bonds, the force of attraction between the combining atoms is going to be increased. With the increase in the force of attraction, what happens, the atoms are tries to come closer, the atoms are try to come closer, come closer varta ide antandre length of the bond, that means the distance between the two nuclei of combining atoms is less. In such cases, how it affects the bond length, it decreases its bond length. That means how the multiplicity of the bonds affects the bond length, means with the increase of a bond length, with the increase of multiplicity, bond length is going to be decreased. Okay, next, greater the, second point, greater the multiplicity, greater the multiplicity of bonds, greater the multiplicity of bonds, less will be its bond length, less will be its bond length, less will be its bond length. Okay, suppose you can take an example of carbon-carbon single bond. In carbon and carbon, they are bounded by single bond. Andre, our bond length is to the 154 picometer. It is of the order of 154 picometer. Suppose if the carbon atoms are bounded by double bond. Double bond andre, multiple bond, multiplicity increase aagta ide. With the increase in the multiplicity, force of attraction increases. Force of attraction increase aadange bond length kadime aagtade, that is why it possesses the bond length of 134 picometer. With the increase in the multiplicity, the bond length is going to be decreased, that is why the bond length has decreases from 154 picometer to 134 picometer. Followed by, if the carbon atoms are bounded by triple bonds, again the multiplicity has increased, number of bonds increased. With the number of bonds, with the increase of number of bonds, what happens, the force of attraction between the combining atoms increases. With the increase in the number of bonds, force of attraction between the combining atoms increases. With the increase in the force of attraction, molecules or atoms which comes closer varta ide andre length of the bond enagtade kadime aagtade, that is why the bond length of carbon-carbon triple bond is 120 picometer. It is of the order of 120 picometer. Okay, these are the factors which affects the bond length. Okay, here we can write it like this: multiplicity of the bonds. Multiplicity of bonds inversely proportional to bond length. ಈ ಥರ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ? ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಸಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್. ಎಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್, ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮೀಟರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, If we want to know about the bond lengths of different compounds or different atoms, that is bond and bond length. Okay, first H2 molecule, or we can write it like this, H2 molecule, the bond length, as I already told, it is having bond length, it is in a picometer. Picometer le represent martivi bond length anna, or angstrom units, picometer, it is having 74 picometer, followed by Cl atom, it is having a Cl atom yesterday 199 picometer it is having. Next HCl, it is having 127 picometer, followed by C and H, they possess 109 picometer, 109 picometer, followed by, with the multiplicity of the bonds, carbon-carbon single bond, it is having 154 picometer, carbon-carbon double bond is having 134 picometer, followed by the last carbon-carbon triple bond, it is having 120 picometer. Okay, here two factors are major responsible for the increase or decrease in the bond length. That is, first thing it is with the increase of their atomic sizes, the second thing is the multiplicity of the bonds. These two things you must remember. Okay, next. So the next important bond parameter, that is bond strength. That is bond strength. Bond strength, or bond energy, or bond dissociation energy. Ella tara idna pronounce martare. Next one, it is bond strength. Bond strength, or bond energy, or bond dissociation energy. Bond dissociation energy, or is represented as bond dissociation energy. Okay, what is meant by this word bond strength, bond energy? If there is a bond present in between atoms, unquote, if we want to break this bond, some amount of energy has required na, in order to break this bond, we have to apply some amount of energy. That energy is nothing but bond energy. It is the amount of energy required to break one mole of bonds. It is the amount of energy. It is the amount of energy required. It is the amount of energy required to break one mole of bonds into its atoms in gaseous state. Okay, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಬಾಂಡನ್ನು, ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡನ್ನು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂಥ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಗೇಷಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಒನ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡನ್ನು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆಟಮ್ಸನ್ನು ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್, ಆರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಆರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಡಿಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಡಿಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಡಿಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ? ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬೈ ಕಿಲೋ ಜೌಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. We can represent bond strength by kilo joule per mole. Okay, next, what are the factors that affects this bond strength? Like the factors affecting the bond length, here also some of the factors which affects the bond strength, that means nearly the same factors which affects this also. Okay, let us look into them one by one. The very first one, it is size of combining atoms. Again, it is same, size of combining atoms. Nodi, size, bond strength or bond energy, strength of a bond which depends upon size of combining atoms. Suppose if the combining atoms are like this, ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಈ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಈಗ, ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಟಮ್, ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಟಮ್, ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಟೂ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೈ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್, ಯಾವಾಗ ಬಾಂಡಿನ ಲೆಂತ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೋ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್? ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೈ ಆಫ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್, ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್. ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್, ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ವೀಕ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಇದನ್ನು ಹೆಚ್ ಟು ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಇದರದ್ದು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ 435.8 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೌಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಅಷ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ Cl2 ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇದರದ್ದು 237 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೌಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. 237 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೌಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ? 74 picometer. 74 picometer ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಟು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ದೆಮ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, 435.8 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೌಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಬಟ್ Cl2, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ H2 ವಿತ್ Cl2, Cl2 ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ನ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ 199 picometer ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ವಿತ್ ದ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಾರಿ ಆಸ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆದಂಗೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ವಿತ್ ದ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಲೆಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ದಿಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ Cl ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ Cl2 ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೈಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ? greater the size of the combining atoms lesser will be the energy required to break the bonds. to break the pot. Halwa, greater the size of the combining atoms. Combining atom size jaasti aagta idenge, bond strength weak aagtade. By giving less amount of energy, we can easily break the atoms. Okay, this is the first one. That means atomic size inversely proportional to bond energy. Alva? Or you can write it as bond length antanadru tagabodu. Bond length and bond energy both are inversely proportional. Okay, next. Next, with the multiplicity of the bonds, second concept, again it is multiplicity. Multiplicity of the bonds. How the multiplicity of the bonds affects the bond energy or bond strength? With the increase in the multiplicity of the bonds, here this carbon atom, these two carbon atoms are bonded by single bond, these two are by double bond, and these two are by triple bond, in which here it is having only one bond. The distance or the force of attraction between these two carbon atoms is less. Force of attraction less ide antandre bond length jaasti ide anta artha. Okay, with the increase of one more bond, with the addition of one more bond, the force of attraction between the combining atoms increased. Force of attraction between the combining atoms increases. Force of attraction increase aagta ide andre bond strength enagtade, bond strength has increased na. Illi force of attraction strong aagide antandre, in order to break this bond, so we have to apply more amount of energy. That is why with the increase in the multiplicity of the bonds, bond strength is going to be increased. Okay, yes, the number of bonds jaasti aagta hogtavo ashtu strength of the bond strong aagta hogtade, followed by a more amount of energy is required for the breaking of bonds. Okay, here if we look into this carbon carbon single bond, it requires around 418 or 400 plus kilojoule per mole energy for the breaking this bond. If we have carbon carbon double bond, it is nearly have 618 something. Okay, it will have carbon carbon triple bond, it is around 800 plus. That means with the increase of multiplicity of the bonds, what happens? Force of attraction between the combining atoms increased. With the increase in the combining force of attraction between the combining atoms, more amount of energy is required for the breakage of this bond. Okay, that is why multiplicity of the bonds is directly proportional to bond energy. Multiplicity of the bonds is directly proportional to bond energy or bond strength. As the multiplicity of the bonds increased, bond energy is also increased. Okay, next, the third most important point, that is lone pair of electrons. Enagtade lone pair of electrons idre, if you take an example of carbon carbon followed by nitrogen nitrogen followed by oxygen oxygen followed by ClCl, by looking into this example, this carbon carbon atom which do not have lone pair of electrons, adralli yavade reethi lone pair of electrons irodilla, because carbon is being tetravalent in nature, it utilizes its all the electrons for getting a stability. Okay, here nitrogen, it is trivalent in nature. After getting a stability, it is having, each nitrogen atom will have two electrons as lone pairs, illi lone pairs of electrons ide, followed by this oxygen atom, it is having a 6 electrons in its valence shell, 2 4 6, nodi illi 6 electrons ide, illu 6 electrons ide, followed by this Cl atom, ClCl atom, both are having 7 electrons in their valence shell, 6 7, 2, 4, 6, 7. Okay, how these electrons affect the bond strength? With the increase in the number of lone pair of electrons on the atoms. Number of lone pair of electrons in the andre, which is electron rich in nature. Illu number of electrons maximum ide, illu number of electrons maximum ide. Again after that there is a repulsive interaction takes place. With the increase in the number of electrons, lone pair of electrons on a combining atoms, what happens? There is a repulsive interaction takes place. ಎಷ್ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತವೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ರಿಪಲ್ಸಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ರಿಪಲ್ಸಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೋ, ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಸಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದಂಗೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ವೀಕ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ವಿತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೋನ್ ಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್, ರಿಪಲ್ಸಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ರಿಪಲ್ಸಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದರೆ strength of the bond is going to be weak. Weak aagtade strength of the bond. Bond weak aadaga we can easily break this bond. Okay, less amount of energy is required by this bond, followed by this bond, followed by this, and followed by this, because this carbon atom which do not have lone pairs, nitrogen will have one lone pair of electrons. Here oxygen we have 3 lone pair of electrons, that means 6 electrons present on each oxygen atom. Repulsions are more, energy requirement is less. Repulsive interactions are even more at this case, and the strength of the bond is weak here. Okay, next, lone pair of electrons on combining atoms inversely proportional to bond energy. Number of electrons ಎಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತವೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತವೋ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಮೋ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ bond angle. Bond angle. Bond angle. What is meant by this word bond angle? Bond angle, name itself indicates that it is an angle. Okay, it is the average angle between the lines. Okay, it is the average angle between the lines representing the atomic orbitals. It is the average distance between the lines, lines under bonds. It is the average distance or average angle between the lines representing an atomic orbital containing a number of electrons. Okay, the lines galu enu, each line represents each atomic orbital, ivugala nadivina angle ide alva adanna naavu bond angle anta karithivi. It is the average angle between the lines andre yavappa bonds. It is average angle between the lines representing orbital, representing atomic orbital, representing atomic orbital containing electrons. Okay, ಯಾವ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಗಳು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ಗಳ ನಡುವಿನ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲನ್ನು ಆ್ಯಾವ್ರೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲನ್ನು ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಓಕೆ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇವೆಲ್ಲದರಲ್ಲೂ ಇದನ್ನು ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೀಥೇನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮೀಥೇನ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇದು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ ಆ್ಯಾವರೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಟಮ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಾವರೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ 109 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 28 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಐದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಲ್ವ ದ ಆ್ಯಾವರೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿಮ್ ಬೈ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಸಿ ಎಚ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಸ್ 109 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 28 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಎಚ್ ಟು ಒ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ 104.5 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ 104.5 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಮೋನಿಯಾ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ ಎಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಈಸ್ 107 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಎಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಟ್ರೈಫ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಈಸ್ 120 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಬೋರಾನ್ ಟ್ರೈಫ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಆ್ಯಾವರೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಎಚ್ ಫೋರ್ ಈಸ್ 109 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 28 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 104.5 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಮೋನಿಯಾ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 107 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಎಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಟು 120 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಓಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಈಸ್ 120 ಇಫ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಈಸ್ 109 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 28 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಮುಂದೆ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಆದರೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಆದರೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೊ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ರೂಲ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಕೂಡ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಏನೇನು ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡೋಣ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ ಇದು ವಿಚ್ ಡಜೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಬರೆದ್ವಲ್ವಾ ಈ ಥರ ಬರೆದ್ವಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರನ್ನು ಸಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಓ ಸಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಓ ಈ ಥರ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಎಸ್ ಈ ಥರ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀವಲ್ಲ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ಲಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್ಸು ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಾಂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರುತ್ತೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ rule or according to Kossel and Lewis, they do not explain the actual shape of the molecules, actual bond angles, yave bond estirutte angle, yave bond length estirutte, adare base mele shape of the molecule anna ivaru explain madodilla. That is the first limitation of this concept. Second one, which this cannot explains about the formation of covalent bond. ಹೀಗಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಯಾಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ? ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಮ್ಯೂಚುವಲ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ನ, ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್. ಒಂದು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಲು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲನ್ನು ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಈ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ Kossel and Lewis concept. According to them, they could not explain the formation of covalent bond. Third one, he could not differentiate the bond strengths and bond angles. If you take an example of H2 molecule na tagolinu, H2 molecule alli bond length eshtu irutadappa, bond length is 74 picometer. And bond energy or bond strength yesterday 435.7 kilojoule irtada, kilojoule per mole. Okay, yesterday the same fluorine atoms nodi, ivulli eradu fluorine atoms ide, ivugaldo atomic size small irtada. This fluorine atom or this fluorine molecule is also formed by sharing a single covalent bond. You will not have a covalent bond today. But when we compare this with a bond length, it is of the order of 155 picometer. Either bond length is 155 picometer, followed by its bond energy, it is 144 kilojoule per mole. Now what is the difference between these two? Here both the atoms are smaller in nature, then here also single covalent bond is there, here also single covalent bond is there, but both are differed by their bond length and bond strength. Okay, and this theory which does not account for this concept. ಓಕೆ, ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇವೊಂದು ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಸೇಮ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ದೇ ಡಿಫರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದೇರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೆವೈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಓವರ್ಕಮ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ covalent bonding, that is valence bond theory. That is valence bond theory. In this theory we are going to understand the limitations of a Kossel and a Lewis concept. Okay, in the next class we will move on to the valence bond theory. Okay.